Alright guys, and welcome back to what is a daily recap, and it's been a long time since we did a daily recap. I think it's about probably a year, or even like 8-9 months since the last time I did a daily recap. So I thought, like, why not just do that one? I didn't do my pre-market analysis. I don't think there's a lot to cover today because we had CPI coming out, and after that prices skyrocketed on EU and GU. However, we have some structure breaks and turnarounds we can cover. So let's just dive in. Got my screen over here now. Laptop is a bit lower, but yeah, let's get into it. So starting on GU, because GU is a rocket, or went rocketing today, taking out previous daily highs here. We can already see that yesterday's candle was so strong. Let me zoom in so you can see it more clearly. There you go. If you look at that candle, it closed above that wick, and there's literally no wick to the upside, indicating that, okay, yesterday is strong, we're going bullish. Price takes out these highs, we turn bullish. We had a purple structure internal here that realigned with the light blue one, so now we have a light blue leg to the upside, and that's our structure we're following. If we zoom in, all we're looking for is discounted pricing on this range, and we are looking to short again, so we're looking for correctional trades, and we can short from these areas there. So that's what we're going to look at. We're not in any discounted areas, so we're not looking for longs. This was a discounted area. I'm better at shorting, so that's why I missed the long trades. I did the case study on that. I showed you the short trade I got. Didn't show you the long trade because I always miss the long trade. Hey, it'd be like that sometimes. Thing I'm noticing here right now is that actually we have a realigned green structure, and that's something major. So we have light blue realigning with green, and that's interesting because then we can work with this entire leg, which means that we can get down here, which means on DXY we can get up there, and that would mean that our analysis is finally playing out. So that's interesting on GU. That also means that we can, if we get into shorts here, we can target these lows now, and from here we can get a move. But we also know that, of course, we have lower pricing still to go, or lower areas where you can still go. We haven't reached back into this discounted area yet of the yellow range, so that's still valid. But this is interesting. This is really interesting. What I'm gonna do now is actually kill some noise here. Keep that on though. There we go. And that's super interesting. I like that. I will just keep it like that. So we have now this leg, and we have this being realigned. So I'm gonna reduce a little bit of noise. Just clean charts, really. React it from there. Oh, my eyes start stripping again. So that's super interesting. What I wanted to do is just cover quickly what happened this week so far, what happened today actually. We can see that price got up here. When we opened today, there wasn't much happening. It was literally price just breaking above here, taking Asia highs. We already took previous daily highs. Look, oh, ugly place to form an Asia previous daily high. Ooh. No trade entries here. Then coming up later, there's no early sellers here, so we get our first set of early sellers around here, where we have a bullish break, bearish break, so we got early sellers here, and this is where a short entry comes from, but not a short trade because it doesn't play out. It's too short. We have a low, high, high, low, higher, high. So this is the area we short from. Break, push to the downside, stop to break even, so would end up in a probably end up in a break even trade or a loss. Well, there wasn't anything. Then during New York, start of New York, there's another trade here. Early sellers, why? Well, we have a low that led to a high. They'd be taken out. Oh, my bad. So this doesn't come above. So that's not early sellers. Okay. No trade during New York. Nice. Stupid. Yeah. So there actually wasn't anything. Then we had CPI news coming out. A strong push to the upside. And this is just, this is so interesting. Like, I can look at these charts, just look at it and keep on looking because this is nice. So we have that bullish breakdown, the weekly, taking out these highs. We know that we, if we go to the daily and make it a bit more stretch, we know that we have this bullish leg here that we reach back into this kind of pricing. We're looking at higher highs, so we might get there, but we also might not get there. Above these highs, what can we see if we go here and so this one, that one, if we draw a little line there just to point out that high, and then we go to lower time frames like 1 hour gaps, 4 hour, perfect. Let's take that one because that's unmitigated, if I'm correct. Taking out, which is, we'll probably take out this one here and then move lower. Let's see. Looks juicy. Wait, there we go. Wicked. Look at that push. And now you can look for sells from this area. We're doing a little backtest session here. Tapped in. Let's go short. Too easy. If you just have patience. Nice. Little backtest there. Okay, well, I needed this one. And pull that across. Did we tap into that before? I think we just missed it. Oh, we just tapped into that. But there's more. There's more, so it's all right. Let's keep it like this. Go out of the replay mode. I have to do it like that. Yes. So this is where we are at right now, and it's a bit tricky with those structures to keep them on, but I do want to look for longs from this discounted area. If we zoom in, we can see there this leg doesn't have much liquidity to it. We have equals here to the downside, which we can't ignore. So yes, we do have this leg here, but keep in mind that we have this overall leg from down here up to up here, and yeah. So there's a high probability that we reach below these lows, take out the equals, and then get a reaction from here, which would mean on DXY that we, if we don't get lower, we get up here because we tapped in. Now we get the turnaround to the upside, GU, turnaround to the downside, take out these lows, meaning take out the highs on G on DXY, take out the highs here. And yeah, let's see for today, or actually what's coming up next is that we're gonna look for shorts. We're gonna look for shorts until we reach this area, then we might start looking for longs depending on the internal structure we form here. If it is nice and clean, we can get a lot of trade entries. If it's more impulsive, then we might be careful a bit more until we reach below here before we look for longs. But we'll see once we get there. Then for EU broke above as well. Took all that. If we look at the daily candle on EU, because I didn't do my pre-market analysis this morning, it's a bit misleading. Come on. Was a bit misleading. Was not a strong candle. However, it had a quite strong closure. So we took out these highs here. We broke bullish. No structure realignments as of yet. Still following that structure there. And what I'm just gonna do is just clean it up. We don't need it. You don't need all the noise. I can see there's a lot going on there. So let's just go lower. That was of the case study. And GU or EU pretty much the same. You can see that we pushed to the upside, and after that there was just nothing. And now we have this lag and react from this area. If you react from here, look, we took everything. We do have some liquidity here, but we took majority of the liquidity of this lag, whatever it is. And if we push lower now, man, like, price is at an area that we can really move short now. Only thing that sits not right with me is these lows here. But we don't know until it happens. We don't know what the plan is of DXY, dollar, EU, GU. So let's see. Yeah, there wasn't as much to cover. We can see the new structures over here. We're still bearish on this one. And we took internal range liquidity on that last push, although we do have more structure to it now. Even if we want to move lower, even though the dark green one doesn't align with the light blue one, sorry, lost my words there. Even though the dark green structure is not aligned with the light blue one, both are in a place where they want to move lower. We are above all the highs. We need to discount the pricing on the green one, and we reach premium on the light blue one, so we want to reach lower on that one as well. So let's see. This was a quick daily recap, or actually just an analysis, me speaking about the charts. Tomorrow morning I will cover this in more detail and see what we can do. Maybe tonight we get some more price action we can work with. And yeah, I'll catch you guys later. If you need anything, if you need help, got questions, just shoot me a DM or comment on my videos. And yeah, catch you guys later. Peace out.